الحمد لله أحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أشهد يا رسول الله أنك قد بلغت الرسالة وأديت الأمانة ونصحت الأمة وكشف الله سبحانه وتعالى بك الغمة وتركتنا على المحاجة البيضاء ليلها واضح كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك ولا يتنكبها إلا خاسر ثم أما بعد أيها الإخوة الأحباب أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذه الجمعة المباركة أن يغفر لي ولكم الذنوب وأن يستر عنا العيوب وأن يحشرني وإياكم في مستقر رحمته تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم اللهم آمين آمين يا رب العالمين Dear brothers, dear sisters in Islam, we should fear Allah Almighty God as He should be feared. I testify that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is a messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, He has sent the prophets and messengers to guide people to His straight path, to Sirat al-Mustaqim, to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He has made some of His prophets and messengers superior upon others. And He gave them some virtues upon others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made five of them, they were superior 100%. Prophet Noah, Prophet Ibrahim, Prophet Moses, Jesus and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he called them Ulul Azmi min ar-Rusul. They were the five powerful messengers, and Ulul Azmi, they were superior in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best of all of them, even these four blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, five Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the master of the children of Adam. Sayyidu walad Adam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also he created too many places. And he made some places very superior too, like Mecca, Medina, Al-Quds, Jabal al-Tur, Sinai, some places. And also he created the time. And he made some time superior too, like the month of Ramadan. Or the day of Jum'ah, he created the days, the day of Jum'ah, like today. It's a superior. It's a superior. And also, he has sent the Holy Quran, Al-Quran Al-Azim, the Noble Quran, the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the whole entire Quran is very superior and has virtues. The Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the Quran is Kalam Allah. But He has made some of the Quran superior also. Even some verses and some surahs. Some verses like what we know, Suratul. Some verses like we know, Ayatul Kursi, It is the greatest verse in the Holy Quran. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. آية الكرسي, the greatest verse in the Holy Quran, it is in Surah Al-Baqarah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made some surah also, very superior, and He gave that surah its virtues upon the whole entire Quran, like Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha. How many times, dear brothers and sisters, we are reciting every day and night in our prayer, and even other time, Surah Al-Fatiha. 17 times we are reciting Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen every day and night. Surah Al-Fatiha. If you say 17 times in Salat Al-Farida and plus Salat Al-Nawafil, it will be 29 times day and night we are reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. But my question is, did you try to understand the meaning of Surah Al-Fatiha? I will tell you something, you're going to be very surprised. Maybe this first time in your life, you're going to listen to what I'm going to say right now. As you know, we agreed all of us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent 4 books and 100 scrolls. He has sent 100 scrolls, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has sent 10 of them to Adam, 50 to Prophet Sheth, 30 to Prophet Idris, and last 10 of the scrolls he sent it to Prophet Ibrahim, Suhuf Ibrahim wa Musa. And these 100 scrolls, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it to some of His prophets, plus the 4 books He has sent, the Psalms of David, they called Az-Zabur to Prophet King David, and the Torah to Prophet Moses, and the Bible or the Scripture to Prophet Jesus, and the Holy Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and this is the final. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He collected all the meanings of the 100 scrolls, plus the Psalms of David, the Torah, the Bible, the scriptures, all of these, its meanings, all of them, into the Holy Quran. Into the Holy Quran. Means when you, that's why Allah said, وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. Who is the Muhaymin? The Quran has the upper hand. Because all the meanings, the rules, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to the Anbiya before, it is in the Holy Quran. Means when you read the Holy Quran, you read the Torah already. And I can tell you, even the 10 commandments, last verses in Surah Al-An'am, the chapter of the Kathir, the whole 10 commandments of the Torah, it is in the Quran. See, whenever you read the Holy Quran, as if you read the Psalms of David, but you have to understand it. The Psalms of David, the Torah, the scriptures, it's all in the Holy Quran. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summarized the whole entire Quran into Surah Al-Fatiha. That's why one of its names, the mother of the book, Ummul Kitab, the mother of the book. Why the mother of the book? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summarized the whole ideas in the Holy Quran and put it in these 7 verses, Surah Al-Fatiha. That's why Allah said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. We have given you, O Muhammad, 7 repeatedly verses. What? And, huh? Wa means and, القرآن العظيم. We give you the seven repeatedly verses equal to والقرآن العظيم and the Holy Quran. Means سورة الفاتحة itself, it is equal to the Holy Quran. And Allah Almighty summarized the whole entire Quran and the whole message in one verse in سورة الفاتحة. We read it every day. What kind of verse? Sheikh, we read it every day. We don't know. I'm going to tell you. That verse said, huh? الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. Not yet. Aywa. What is the verse? إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. This is a verse. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. This is a verse. When you read إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, you read the whole entire book. You read the whole entire Quran. You read the Torah. You read the Psalms of David. You read the scriptures. You read the whole entire Quran. That's it. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did create us? توحيد الألوهية وتوحيد الربوبية. إياك نعبد توحيد الألوهية. You are Allah, we are worshipping you alone. You are my God. You are my إله. إياك نعبد. All of us worship you. وإياك نستعين. توحيد الربوبية. توحيد الربوبية. The Islamic monotheism. توحيد الألوهية. إياك نعبد. And توحيد الربوبية. Oh Allah, help us. Guide us to worship you. Help us to worship you. وإياك نستعين. We seek your help. This is توحيد الربوبية. Plus the رحمة of Allah. الرحمن الرحيم. That's why, dear brothers, we have to know what you are reciting. سورة الفاتحة. I'm going to tell you the superiority of this surah right now. I wish if the time just will give me a chance. Okay. Now, as we know, Surah Al-Fatiha has too many names. Ayat Al-Kursi, if you recite it before you sleep, every night Allah will appoint a guard, an angel, to guard you until morning. And if you recite Ayat al-Kursi after each Salah, nothing can stop you from entering Jannah except death. Just die, you will go to Jannah. Because you recite Ayat al-Kursi after every Salah. Subhanallah, don't miss it. What about Surah al-Fatiha? What about Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad? Surah al-Ikhlas. It's equal to the one third of the whole Quran. If you read Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad, Allahu Samad, Lam Yalid, Wa Lam Yulad, Wa Lam Yakun Lahu Kufuwan Ahad, as if you read one third of the whole Quran, means you're going to be rewarded as if you read one third of the whole Quran. If you read it one time, you read it twice, two thirds, you read it three times, you're going to be rewarded as if you recite the whole entire Quran. See, you have to know this case, but let's focus about Surah Al-Fatiha now. Surah Al-Fatiha, through Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Fatiha, you will know your God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah said السبع المثاني. What is the meaning of السبع المثاني? The seven repeatedly verses means we repeat the surah in the whenever we pray, we repeat it time after time after time. And in when you make two rak'ahs, you have to read al-Fatiha twice. That's why seven repeatedly verses, you have to read it. Very important. So through surah al-Fatiha, you will know Allah Azza wa Jal, your God. Allah, Bismillah, He's your God. رب العالمين, who's your Lord. توحيد الربوبية. الرحمن, الرحيم. These are some of the beautiful attributes or names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Fatiha. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن, الرحيم. See, subhanAllah, these names. Surah, you know your aqeedah and creed when you read it. Tawheed al-uluhiyya, the Islamic monotheism. And tawheed al-rububiyya, Allah is your God. Allah is the one who is feeding you, protecting you, giving you shifa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your life in His hand. This is He's your Lord, He's your God. He's your God, He's your Lord. That's called tawheed al-rububiyya. Iyaka na'budu uluhiyya, iyaka nasta'in rububiyya. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم بأي الرحمة يا رب العالمين.
And Alhamd, one of its names, Surah Alhamd. Surah Alhamd. That's why from the Sunnah, if you are Imam or you are praying, to recite al Basmala, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, silently, and you start with Surah Alhamd. You start with saying, Alhamdulillah. All praises are due to Allah, the Lord of all mankind. Rabbil Alameen. And Alif Lam, when you say Al, means the in English. The praises, Alhamd, all praises. In Arabic grammar, they call it Alif Lam lil-istighraq, يعني كل الحمد. كل الحمد means all praises are due to Allah, Almighty Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. That's when we, if I ask you, which one is better, Alhamd or Al-Shukr? Alhamd, better. One of the names of Surah Al-Hamd, Al-Fatiha, Al-Hamd. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He being praised by all of His creatures. Surah Al-Fatiha talks about the day of judgment. Maliki Yawm al-Din, Yawm al-Mi'ad, the day of reckoning, the day of accountability. And everybody will stand in the court of Allah, and Allah will punishes somebody and he will reward somebody, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone else, Maliki Yawm al-Din, he is the only judge there, and he will judge between people by justice, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Fatiha talks about an-nubuwat, the prophecy, prophets and messengers, subhanallah. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them to guide people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight way, straight path. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. The way of those whom you bestowed your ni'mah, favor. And that verse being explained by another verse. ومن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. May Allah make me and you all amongst them. Say Ameen inshallah. Ya Rabbal Alameen. If you obey Allah, the condition according to the verse, whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, he will be admitted with an-nabiyyin. I'm not a Nabi, I'm not a messenger, but you will be with them because you obey Allah and the Rasul. They call it in Arabic, al-shart wa jawab al-shart. Whosoever obeys, he will get this. This is the shart. What is the condition? To obey Allah and the Rasul. What is the reward? To be with the Nabiyyin and the Siddiqeen, with the Shuhada and the Salihin, the pious ones, and those who are similar to them. Even if I'm not a Nabi, I'm gonna be with the Anbiya, yes. With the Shaheed, yes. With Abu Bakr al-Siddiqin, yes. Why? Because I obeyed Allah and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for the importance of Surah Al-Fatiha, ya jama'a, we read the Quran every day and night, especially this Surah, the greatest Surah in the Holy Quran, and we don't know its meaning. When you read it, you are talking to Allah. You are talking to Allah. Yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Hadith al-Qudsi, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِ قِسْمَيْنِ فَإِذَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Stop. Don't go to another verse. Allah is talking to you. Allah will say, حَمَدَنِي عَبْدِي. If the servant of Allah say, الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, Allah will answer and He will say, my servants praised me. He has praised me. For that's why, dear brothers, even when you recite Surah Al-Fatiha, don't recite it just like that. Stop in the Ra'us al-Ayat. When the ayah finished, stop, take your time. Because Allah is talking to you. And if the servant of Allah say, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah will say, Athna alayya abdi. My servant praised me again. And he say, Maliki Yawm al-Din. And Allah will say, Majjadani abdi. And the rest of Surah Al-Fatiha dua. When you finish it, Allah will say, هذا لعبدي ولعبدي ما سأل. Whatever you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by this surah, Allah will give it to you. When you say, Iyyaka na'bud, wa Allah will shibu, Iyyaka nasta'in, help me, guide me, Allah will give it to you. Any letter you ask, Rasulullah said that, any letter you say it in Surah Al-Fatiha, and the last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, Aman al-Rasul, last two ayah, Lillahi ma fi samawati wa fi al-ardu, intubdu ma fi anfusikum, Aman al-Rasul, the last two ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah. Any letter, any dua you ask Allah by these two ayat and Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah will give it to you. You get it, guaranteed, Rasulullah said that. أن تدعو بأي حرف من هذه السور إلا أعطاك الله سبحانه وتعالى إياه. You will get it, there is no doubt. فجماعة, when you read Surah Al-Fatiha, you are talking to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding, answering you. You have to feel it. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Stop. Last token. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. 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 If you say آمين and the ملائكة will say آمين with you, Allah will forgive your sin. See how many times every day you are reciting Surah Al-Fatiha and you don't know the value of what you are saying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will give you this hadith right now, but just let's go because the time with the names of Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah called it Fatihat al-Kitab, the opening of the book. Fatihat al-Kitab. When you open the door, say, iftah al-bab, open the door. Fatihat al-Kitab, iftah, open. It's the opening of the Holy Quran. That's why Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in that hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and the Muslim, لا صلاة لمن لم يقرأ بفاتحة الكتاب. There is your salah, namaz. Your salah will not be accepted if you will not recite Surah Al-Fatiha in your salah. Not just that. Another hadith said, فصلاته خداج. خداج means even if you recite it, but not in the correct way. That's why you have to sit with any sheikh to correct yourself in Surah Al-Fatiha. Otherwise, your salah will not be accepted. Take it from me, fatwa. I'm telling you, wallahi. Somebody can say, Ya Shaykh, احنا وريد يتلاقى. No, 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 no. Rasulullah said, من لم يقرأ بسورة سورة الفاتحة فصلاته خداج or خداج. خداج means or خداج is not complete, is not perfect. Some people, they say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. This wrong. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. إذا أنعمت, أنعمت أنا. أنعمت أنت, الله. Instead of بش, instead of زبر, he's putting بش. Instead of فتحة كسرة ضمة. Changing the meaning. It's called لحن جلي هذا. لحن جلي. It's haram in the Quran. Especially سورة الفاتحة. Because your salah must be correct and perfect. Especially سورة الفاتحة. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said. سورة الفاتحة, one of its names, أم الكتاب. The mother of the book. The mother of the book. Yes. The mother of the book. Look at hadith Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. He was with a group of the Sahaba. They were passing by a tribe of Arab tribe, and the leader of that tribe, subhanallah, the snake or scorpion was biting him, was biting him up. And subhanallah, they asked them for food, they refused, they rejected them, and then they said, anyone can make ruqya for this man, the man gonna die. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, Sahabi, he went there and he was reciting Surah Al-Fatiha for him, and the man became good. And they give them a lot of sheep, a lot of things, because that he saved the guy. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, Ya Abu Sa'id, how do you know Surah Al-Fatiha is ruqya? Ruqya to read for somebody sick. I said, Ya Rasulullah, I just read it. He said, you read Umm al-Kitab, the mother of the book. When you recite Al-Fatiha, you read the whole entire messages, the revelation. The revelation, subhanAllah. As-sab' al-mathani. As-sab' al-mathani. The seven repeatedly verses, also وأم القرآن, the mother of the Quran, الرقية والشافية والكافية, It will satisfy you. Subhanallah. Look at this hadith. There is nothing in the Torah, the Zabur, in the scriptures similar to Surah Al-Fatiha. Nothing. I told you Surah Al-Fatiha is the mother of the Quran, the main thing. Allah summarized the whole entire message and He put it in Surah Al-Fatiha. He summarized the whole entire Surah Al-Fatiha and the message He put it in Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in. I will finish my khutbah with this hadith because of time. في حديث عبد الله بن عباس قال بينما جبريل قاعد عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سمع نقيضا من فوقه فرفع رأسه فقال هذا باب من السماء فتح اليوم لم يفتح قط إلا اليوم فنزل منه ملك فقال هذا ملك نزل إلى الأرض لم ينزل قط إلا اليوم فسلم the angel سلم say سلام to them وقال أبشر to رسول الله أبشر بنورين أوتيتهما لم يؤتهما نبي قبلك he said فاتحة الكتاب وخواتيم سورة البقرة لن تقرأ بحرف منهما إلا أعطيته that hadith narrated by Imam Muslim رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting with angel Gabriel and angel Gabriel suddenly he raised his head up and they said I am listening to naqid. What is naqid? The sound, like when you open the door. When you open the door, it makes sound. That door in the heaven never been opened before. Never. And the special angel never came to the earth. He came to Rasulullah to give him two lights. What? Surah Al-Fatiha and the last ayah, last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. There is no Nabi get something like that. Imagine that special angel from a special door. He never, that door never been opened before. And Jibreel was listening to the sound, the qid, sound of the door. Like this, opening. And they say, oh, Abshir, good news, Ya Muhammad. This is good news for you and your ummah. What? You get Surah Al-Fatiha and the last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah. Whatever you ask Allah with this Quran, Allah will give it to you. Subhanallah. When Ibn Al-Qayyim, radiallahu anhu, he said, to cure yourself from al-kibr, being arrogant, and from al-riya, being showing off when you make something, and not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, read, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. When you say, Iyaka na'bud, you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, means there is no riya. Riya means showing off. You make something not for the sake of Allah. When you say, Iyaka na'budu, Ya Rabb, we worship you alone. Qul inna salati, ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله 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 رب العالمين وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين my صلاة my نسك my life my death my عبادة so only for Allah رب العالمين this is Islam full submission submit yourself to Allah فهون يسأل إياك نعبد من نور يا your عمل will be sincere to Allah only alone And when you say, Iyaka nasta'in, that will break your arrogance. There is no kibr. Ya Rabbi, help me. I'm miskin. I'm poor. Allah loves you to do that. He loves us to do that. Ya Rabbi, I'm miskin. I'm poor. Ya Rabbi, accept from me. And the surah said, Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Allah guide us to the right path. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. That sirat, that way of the right path, it is not the way of those who get... Those people who get your wrath because these people, they have fasad in their qasd because they know the truth and they did not follow it. وَالضَّلِّين they don't have knowledge. They have corruption in their knowledge. فساد العلم. الذين جهلوا الحق ولم يعرفوا. They are ignorant. They don't know the truth. And maybe somebody going to tell me, Sheikh, that ayah is talking about Christian and Jewish. I will say no. Some Muslims, they have the same characteristics. Why you put it in the back of the Christian and Jewish people? Yes, because some of us Syrians, they say that. I disagree with that. Even in my tafsir, I did not mention that Christian or Jewish. This, for everybody, Quran, and if you study the Quranic science, Al-Quran, بعموم اللفظ وليس بخصوص السبب. If Allah sent the ayah, or verse, or order to Bani Israel during the time of Musa, it's for us too. It is not just for them. It is not for the khusus, it is umum for everybody. For this ayah, it's also for Muslims. Too many Muslims, they know the truth and they are going to a different direction. Too many Muslims, they don't know nothing. They are ignorant, dalleen too. Why you put it in the shoulder of others? Fix yourself. Look at yourself first and ask Allah hidayah for everybody, inshallah. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوبون توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه يغفر لكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي المؤمنين وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear brothers, dear sisters, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi al-Alameen, to give us all more understanding of the Holy Quran. We have a treasure, jama'ah. Quran al-Kareem is a treasure. Really, if you read the Quran, you're going to feel different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will solve your problems. There is no sickness with the Quran. It's a cure, wallahi cure. There is no corona, there is no any sickness with the Quran. Read the Quran. Allah said in too many ayat. If Allah sent this Quran to the mountain will crack. If Surah Al-Ra'd, verse number 31, go read it, the chapter of the thunder. Verse number 31, read it. Do you know what the verse says? وَلَوْ أَنَّ قُرْآنًا سُيِّرَتْ بِهِ الْجِبَالِ أَوْ قُطِّعَتْ بِهِ الْأَرْضِ أَوْ كُلِّمَ بِهِ الْمَوْتَى بَلْ لِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ جَمِيعًا. The verse said, if it will be a Quran to move a mountain from its place or to cut the earth, the land with it, like subhanallah, or to talk to the dead people with this Quran, it will be our Quran. It will be our Quran. That's why you have to know the value of the Quran. Read it, understand it, love it. Don't just put it under your books, just throw it somewhere like that. Put it above everybody, above your head, kiss it. Put it in your heart, above your heart. Read it, understand it. The Quran al-Kareem is very important in your life. Don't miss it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made that miracle for us until the day of judgment. Every Nabi, he came with the miracle and he died, he took his miracle with him. But Rasulullah died, but he left the Quran with us. Read it, understand it, love it. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi Alameen, to honor all of us by the Holy Quran and try to teach your kids the Quran al-Kareem too. Please, jama'ah, the masjid needs your help. Again and again and again and again. Please help the masjid. يعني every Friday, we get $100 to $200. It's not paying even the electricity. I know it's a responsibility for every Muslim. At least, يعني give some sadaqah, inshallah, to the masjid, بإذن الله عز وجل, inshallah. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi al-Alameen, أن يبارك لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم يا رب العالمين اجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا وشفاء همومنا وأحزاننا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ألبسنا به الحلل وأسكننا به الظلل واجعله شفيعا لنا وحجة لنا يوم القيامة يا أرحم الراحمين يا عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى ينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم اذكركم وأقم الصلاة